Dear friends, wow. Waking up today, I, like many of you, continue to be in shock, having a feeling of outrage and fury grow, and also recognizing a deep sadness and a pervading concern. We are in the middle of something that did not start yesterday. Yesterday's insurgents and attack on our democracy was the culmination of a long, well-nurtured, sustained hate, consistent spewing of rhetoric and lies, and an elevation of white supremacy culture in this country that has been present, well, since the beginning of this country. Today, we are feeling the effects of yesterday's choices. Today, we recognize that our words matter. What we do, what we say in the private of our own homes, what we do and what we say to each other, out into the world, in our communities, they matter. As Unitarian Universalists, we strive to spread love, we work to build justice, and we commit to living in peace. But love and justice and peace, they're action words. And while we each sit and process the events of the last 24 hours, we must also use that shock and that outrage and that sadness to inspire us to do anything and everything we can in our individual power and in the power that we hold as a community to really work for that love, to work for justice, and to work for peace. To ensure that the ideology that is fueling the hate, that is dismantling our country's state house, is dismantled. It's appropriate that this Sunday we are going to explore prayer, for prayer has the power to help us find our own strength, to help us gain clarity, and to help us feel the love of each other that we so clearly want to feel in the world for everyone. So please join us this Sunday. We need each other now more than ever. Our Sunday service will be at 9:45 via Zoom, as we started last week. The title of the service is Holding You in My Prayers. It was wonderful last week to see everyone in the little squares, and I know not as good as seeing each other in person, but it really was heartening to see all of you. So I really invite you to please join us live, if at all possible, at 9:45. The chat room will be open so you can say hi to friends that you haven't seen in a while. And then please plan to stay afterwards for our fellowship time. It happens right in the same room. We break up into smaller groups just to be able to have some conversations and get to know each other. And then, as always, our second hour activities will be available as well. And then please do look in the email that contained this video message. There's a list of this week's activities at the congregation, as well as in the notebook. So please do take time always to read your notebook, hear what's going on, decide how you and your family can get involved to really live our values in the world. So I will hold you in my prayers this week, that you may feel peace, that you may feel love, and that you may feel that burning desire for justice and know with clarity what it is that you can do to create the world we all want to live in. Blessed be. I love you all, and I look forward to seeing you on Sunday.